The first one, very very important and quite very interesting, is the approach of sperms to the ovum or chemical attraction. The approach of sperms to the ovum or chemical attraction. Second is capacitation. Capacitation, what is the capacity? Okay, next is the acrosomal reactions. Block of polyspermie. Fifth is amphimixis. And last one is the formation of zygote. Now let us discuss each and every one in detail. The first one is the approach of sperms to the ovum or chemical attraction. Why I am telling this as chemical attraction means, when you explain then you will be following. See, as you know, this is the female reproductive system, and you know that it is a pear shaped structure. This is the fallopian tubule, yes or no? The fallopian tubule, which are finger like structures. This is the nearer part is called as the infundibulum, followed by the ampulla, and this is what is fundus, and these are the fimbriae. As you all know, this is the structure, and the connection is called as the ovarian tissue. See, after during the process of fertilization, the sperms enters through the vagina. Is it not? The sperms enters through the vagina. One sperm will not come. I told you already in my previous class, in that particular semen, the sperms will be swimming. Is it not? The motility, maturation, MMS, I told you. So what is happening? So many will enter. But do the sperms have any eye? Can they see? No. What is happening here exactly is, I told you, two ovaries are present. In the menstrual cycle, we have seen that one ovary will be coming. This is the right ovary, this is the left ovary. What is happening? From the one ovary, in the first month, the ovary will come from the left side. In the next month, the ovary will come from the right side. So every time the ova or the egg will not come from the same side. It will be altering. Then how do the sperms identify this? When they enter, they should know. They don't have any eye to go and recognize the egg. So what is happening? The egg will come and travel and sit here. As I told you, they will be lodged here. So from which region it is coming? The sperms, only the human sperms have this capacity of identifying the egg by the help of these chemicals. So what is happening? On the sperms of humans, there will be chemicals which are scattered like this, and even on the egg, the chemicals will be present. So when they are not having any eye, they don't have any eye. So this chemical attraction will be pulling the sperms nearer to the egg region. Are you following? So this is the first step, that is approach of the sperms to the ovum through the chemical attraction, and hence fertilization occurs. This is the first one. And the next is capacitation. What is meant by capacitation? That means when you see the, I'll be showing a next diagram wherein you can understand the process of capacitation. That means the egg, already in my previous classes I have explained you how the egg will be. The egg will be surrounded by germinal epithelium. Okay, the egg will be surrounded by germinal epithelium, and also egg will be having the protective layer like this, protective layer which is called as zona radiata. So what is meant by capacitation? The sperms, after reaching the egg, they have to break this wall of zona radiata. All the sperms cannot fertilize one egg. Only one sperm will be able to break this zona radiata. Are you following? Only one sperm. There will be one layer which will be here somewhere near the zona radiata. A small layer which is very thin, and this zona radiata layer will also be very thin, wherein which sperm is going first, then only that particular sperm will enter into the egg, and hence the process of fertilization occurs. This is called as capacitation. All the sperms cannot enter into the egg. Once the this particular sperm enters, immediately inside, immediately within seconds, a thick layer will be formed. Within seconds, not even nanoseconds, you cannot measure the time. A thick layer will be formed and no other sperm can enter into this egg. Only one sperm will go. Then you may get a doubt of birth of twins. How this will occur? Yes. This is one question where in the JIPMER and also in the NEET examination they have asked, is that during this time in some females, what happens? Maybe two sperms enter through this thin layer, they recognize at the same time, and hence when two sperms enter, then the chances of twins are there. Again, the condition, the genetics, environmental conditions, all depends here, which is not needed for you now. You have to remember only this thing, that what is meant by capacitation. Understood? This is about capacitation. Now the next is the acrosomal reactions. What is meant by acrosome? See, already we will be discussing, I have discussed in the previous class about the structure of the sperm. There you have seen that the sperm is having a pear structure. It is having a pear shaped structure with structure something like that. Okay, so this is the structure of the sperm. Inside this is the head region, you find a cap like structure. If you take this as the sperm is divided into three regions: head region, neck region and the tail region. This is the head, this is the neck, and this is the tail region. So what is happening here in the middle region, you find below the neck, you find a spindle shaped or spiral shaped mitochondria. Very, very important. Spiral shaped mitochondria is present below the neck region, which is giving lots of energy. As you know, mitochondria are the banks of the energy, ATP, adenosine triphosphate. So the head region, as I am telling you, it is having a cap-like structure. This is called as acrosome. This is called as the acrosome. What is the function of acrosome? Acrosome will have lots and lots of enzymes embedded in it. Why it is needed? During this process of fertilization, the acrosomal, all the reactions will be opening. Why? Because as I told you, they have to penetrate into the egg, breaking the zona radiata, and also it has to dissolve all the chemicals which are there in this particular transparent, at that particular one spot, that is transparent region. What are the enzymes that are having this acrosome? The hyaluronidase enzyme, very important. The hyaluronidase enzyme, zona lysine, acrosin, and corna penetrating enzyme. So all these enzymes will be seen in the head of the sperm, and thus they dissolve all these things and enter into the egg. This is what is called as acrosomal reactions. Now next is block of polyspermy. Just now I have explained this also. So all the sperms cannot penetrate at a time, so only one sperm will enter. So this is called as block of polyspermy. Poly means many, sperms means so many sperms cannot enter. So this is called as the block, only one will go. And next is the amphimixis. Amphimixis means the fusion of the gametes. The fusion of the gametes is called as amphimixis. And the last one is the formation of zygote. Thus, after amphimixis, that is the fusion of male and the female gamete, what happens here? The zygote will be formed in the uterus. The zygote will be implanted. The zygote will be implanted in the uterus. This is called as the formation of zygote.